guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be working, we'll show you how to remove or replace throttle body on a Chevy 1.8 EcoTec engine. If you have a Chevy Cruze or Chevy Sonic, guys, Chevrolet Sonic as well, both of the vehicles will be covered. So stay with us, guys, that's what we'll be doing. In the meantime, guys, we'll have more than 200 videos on this Chevy Cruze and on every car we get at the shop. We'll be also adding the 1.4 engine very soon. All the tools and parts, including the replacement throttle body, could be found listed in the description of the video below. So, let's go ahead and start on it.
You can also, guys, find more electrical videos about this car listed on our second channel, Electrical Car Repair Life. Please check it out. Now, first, what do we need to do? We need to go ahead and open the hood. You need to support it. Perfect. Now, again, this is for the 1.8 engine. However, if you have the 1.4, the procedure might not be much different. Now, let me show you what needs to be done. If you follow your intake here, it's going to go to your throttle body, which is located, right here. Now, about that throttle body, guys, that throttle body, it's part of the cooling system. So, what do we do, guys? We'll need to drain the coolant in order to do that, because otherwise we're going to leak a lot of coolant now. So stay with us, guys, and we'll show you how to do that. So we'll first need to drain the coolant, guys, so we can remove the throttle body because we have a few cooler lines. Let's go ahead, do that, and we'll continue with the next step. So for draining the coolant, guys, I would recommend to have the car engine really cold, so leave it overnight, to make sure that the coolant, the engine is cold. Also, you want to, open that cap before you start a little bit to, open it all the way for a little bit to get the pressure out of the system, if there is any pressure. Because if the system is under pressure and if it's hot coolant, it can severely burn you and cause really bad injuries. So let's go ahead and start on it now. So I'm going under the car now. We're going to need a Torx 20 star looking bit. And you can see, guys, this cover here now. This is the cover for the bumper. And if we come all the way here, there is one bolt. Once I remove it, guys, I'll be able to show you where exactly it is. One screw. Now we have one more here. One more next to it. These two, you don't need to get them. Check it out. Now these two are a separate thing. Then we need to get this one here. One more on this side. And then, guys, I need to go on this side. This is the passenger side of the vehicle. And we have one more guy holding in the corner right there. So let me see. What else is holding here now? If we have anything else holding. And all you do, guys, you pull back. And you pull it out. You can see just like that. Now you can see your radiators here as well. The condenser, all that is here. Guys, so now we're on the passenger side of the vehicle. And if we come underneath. You can see that white thing there. This is your radiator, drain plug. So, let me get him here. All we have to do, grab this guy. Wear gloves, always. We have a bucket underneath ready to catch it. It's going everywhere now. So as you can see, guys, I removed the whole pork now. I'll let it drain like that for a little bit. Okay, you can see it acts like it's not getting enough air in the system. So what we can do, okay, we can go on top and we can release, okay, the cap right here. Okay, and it's going to go really, really big time. So let's get one person to remove this cap. Okay, and while we're removing it, I'm going to adjust the bucket to make sure that we catch everything. Okay, check it out now. It's coming real nice. So, perfect. We will let it drain, guys, like that for probably about 5 minutes to make sure everything comes out. Okay, you can see it decreased now. And we'll continue with the next step. So, all we have to do now, guys, okay, we're ready to continue. We can go ahead and install our drain plug. Always use gloves, guys, when you're touching coolant. Don't ask why I don't use it, but it's very poisonous, so always use gloves. Okay. Okay, perfect. Get it tight by hand. Okay, and we're ready here. So you can see now, guys, okay, this is the throttle body right here. Okay, we'll need to remove that hose. I'm going to get that hose out of the way so it's not here and it's not in the way. So what I'll do, I'll just get a screwdriver now, flathead screwdriver. Get that clamp loose. Okay, now there is one more clamp. Okay, right here I need to get a short screwdriver. So let me go ahead and get one shorter screwdriver so I can reach. Or we can actually even use a small socket if we need to, but I think this one will be amazing. You can check out, guys, all the tools and parts that we use in the description of the video below. So coming this way, okay, you can see, okay, where this one is. So, okay, we just grab it, okay. Okay, this one is still holding on the bottom a little bit. So I need to just get it a little bit more loose. Okay, let's see if we can pull the hose now. Okay, guys, this is it. You can see that's the intake boot out of the way. So we'll leave it there. Now you can see we can get to the throttle body. This is your throttle body. How we, guys, disconnect it first. Okay, you can see we have one coolant line here. We have a vacuum hose and we have another coolant line here. Okay, but this one will not need to be removed because it's a circulation in the throttle body. And we have one more right here that goes towards the overflow bottle. So I'll just get small pliers now. Okay, and we'll remove this clamp. Okay, right here. You have to be extremely careful not to break that plastic pipe. Okay, this one will be a little bit stuck. So let me just pull it out a little bit. I need to pull that thing up. Come on. Okay, it's getting there. Okay, perfect. I'm going to grab that hose and just gently, you have to be extremely careful not to damage it. Okay, gently just turn it. Okay, so it can get loose. And I cannot get it with a screwdriver because there is no place to pry on it on the bottom, so I'm just gonna grab it like that. Okay, and it broke loose now. Still stuck quite a bit. So even though we drain the coolant, some will probably come out. Okay, eventually. Okay, you can see I removed it because there will be still some coolant in the throttle body because you cannot drain it unless you remove it. Now we'll need to go ahead, guys. Okay, and remove. Okay, that hose right here. And this is a clamp that I'll have to use a small screwdriver. Okay, this it has a spring on the back side. Okay, hold it with one finger so it doesn't come out. Okay, this thing is a little bit stuck on one side. So I need to push on it. Perfect. Now when the spring comes out like that in this canal, okay, you will be ready to pull that, okay, that hose out of the way. Now we have one little hose right here, guys. Okay, this is a coolant hose as well. This is a little bit tricky, okay, to remove. So you need to spread it on both sides. So you need to press in here. Okay, and start pulling that thing out. So you can remove it from here, or you can disconnect it from the overflow tank, okay, and pull it the whole thing. But I'll just disconnect it from here, guys. It's easier. Okay, press in the middle here, gently wiggle it. Okay, it came out. You can see just like that. Now we have, guys. Okay, we have four bolts that we need to remove. So these four bolts now, guys. 1, 2, 3. Four are with Torx 30, start looking bit. Okay, and we're going to remove each one of them now. Okay, one's loose. Second one. Third, and this is the fourth one. Careful not to drop anything in your throttle body, because if you do, you will have to remove the intake to clean it, otherwise you can severely damage your engine. Now I'm going to pull the bolts out one at a time. 1, 2, 3, four bolts, guys. Four bolts. Now let's see if we have anything else holding here, and I don't think we do. All we have to do is disconnect our wire, okay, right here. Press down. Okay, you need to press down and then pull it out. And this is, guys, the throttle body out of the car. You can see it came out, okay, just like that. So that's how you guys remove it. Check out the description of the video below if you need to check out, okay, where we get our parts from. If you need to get a replacement one, we also have a video to show you how to clean that one. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.